today's adventure.
Here's the backstory of this. I have wanted to experience Raising Cane's like my whole life. The cane sauce, like everybody talks about it.
Everybody talks about it.
But you like can't find them around here. Like they're all like in the South. But I just found out that there's one in Oakland, like in Pittsburgh, like an hour away. They just put one in Pittsburgh. And so we're going to Raising Cane's and I'm very excited.
Dude.
So Mr. Checkeye's cousin's husband is like upper management for Raising Cane's and says that they're like on a mission to like expand Northeast.
Yeah.
And so they're putting them like all over Pennsylvania. We're going to get it. All of our dreams are going to be fulfilled in this moment.
If it's bad, I'm gonna cry.
Yeah, literally, if it's bad, I'm gonna be disappointed.
Yeah, if it's good, we're bringing the whole party.
We're bringing a whole gang.
Bring everybody.
To Oakland. Also, I was looking at the hours of this place, and they're like, during the week, they're open until midnight. And then like on the weekends, they're open until like 2 a.m. Who is at who is working at Raising Cane's at 2 in the morning? Those Pitt students must be eating good. Their way down.
I'm gonna crash the car. No hands.
Put your... Status report later.
Yo.
Okay. Okay, so we finally found parking after forever. Now we're walking to the place.
We're getting there.
We've definitely been here before.
Yeah.
The guy on the skateboard. Oh my gosh.
Skateboard.
Ooh, a witch shop. A witch shop.
Oh boy.
Take a ride on Fifth Avenue.
So we will update you when we have the food.
The chicken.
The chicken. They had a security guard.
They had a dude up front checking you for mobile.
There's a lot of people here. Like a lot of people. Oh, it looks so good. I'm so excited. Oh, there's a dog.
What's the dog doing?
Well, can you please spam me some chicken?
My curfew is 9 p.m. on the weeknights. I'm serious though. Okay, the sweet tea, what would you rate it?
Solid 7.5.
7.5. I would probably also rate it like an 8.
Like 7 to 8 range.
Check this place out. They've got disco balls and like all the, like the cute little sitting areas. It's very nice. So we're vibing.
There's like 40 people in line.
It is here. He went to get forks. I'm vlogging. Alright, this is the moment. Here we go. That is not what I thought it was going to taste like.
In a good way?
Taste it.
Can I press chicken for cheese and more?
It's like a tangy mayo.
I thought it was going to be sweeter.
I like it though.
I like it.
Always judge a restaurant by their coleslaw. There's the coleslaw.
What'd you rate the coleslaw? Ooh, that's really good.
8 or a 9 is very refreshing.
I'll give that like a 9. That's pretty good coleslaw.
Rough fry.
I like it.
It's a standard fry.
They were saying that they weren't gonna be that good, but I like it. Okay, with the cane sauce.
It's a very basic.
That's pretty good. I'll give that a 9 too.
I'd say 8, 9 range.
Mr. Check, I said this was the best part.
Texas.
And that when he goes to Cane's, he substitutes the coleslaw for more toast. And said that the next time he goes, he's gonna get, instead of fries, more toast. So this better be good. I like, okay, with the cane sauce.
With the cane sauce?
That's what people do, dog. That's really freaking good. Oh man, that's good. That's a 10. That is a 10. Oh my gosh, he was right. Mr. Sanger, you were right. If you're seeing this, you were right.
He was right. You were right. I'm gonna golf this now.
So, yeah, all right, we'll see you later. We're gonna eat this. So Landon and I were talking, but he does this thing.
Okay, so I'm eating food, right? Let's use this as an example. We got 2 tenders left, got a lot of fries, and like about half a sweet tea left, right? You wanna evenly eat it down until you have like one bite of your food left, and it should be the best bite of each section. You want those to the end. One bite of my tenders left. I just ate my last bite of coleslaw. I got like no sweet tea left in. So have the best bite at the end and it'll work out. Don't judge me.
So
There's that. We're also unpacking that.
So, overall, I think this trip was worth it. I'd give the restaurant itself, like, a good 9.
And the atmosphere was very nice.
Oh, yeah. And the food was good, and the service was good. It was crowded, but it didn't take that long. I think the best part was the toast.
Really?
Mr. Chekai, I think, was right.
Yeah, they get smashed.
And the coleslaw? The
pretty
coleslaw.
Oh, the coleslaw. And the sauce is free. You guys, for extra, it's free.
It's not free.
It's 40 cents. Oh, ice cream?
I kind of do.
No. I'll get you ice cream, okay? If that's what you want.
Driving in this car, like, I have my feet positioned as if they were on the brake and the gas. Because whenever you get too close to the car in front of you, I, like, brake. Like, my feet, like, need to brake. Anyways, overall, I'd rate the experience a 10 out of 10. Very pleasurable experience. Careful, careful, careful. Why are you taking the exit?
Well, because I forgot.
Alright. Okay, so now we're going the wrong direction. This is a horrifying
You wanna
experience.
Drive?
Oh my goodness. Oh,
we're gonna document our first fight on camera.
It's okay. It's okay.
You just threatened me on camera!
Roll the tape.
I didn't know the right lane went into it. Are you still vlogging?
Why are you yelling at me? Why are you yelling at me?
Okay, anyways.